I confess to my Lord.
According to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, my Lord.
chapter 17, verses 26 to 37. On the day when the Son of Man is revealed, Jesus said to his disciples, "As it was in the day of Noah, so will be in the day of the Son of Man. People were eating and drinking, they got married, and they given in marriage until the day of Noah entered the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all. Likewise, as it was in the day of Lot, they ate, drank, and brought, they sold, they planted, and they built. But the day came, the Lot went out from the Sidon, and fire and brimstone rained over them, and they were destroyed. So will be in the day of the Son of Man is to reveal. On that day, let him, one who is on the housetop with his goods in the house, not come down to take them away. And likewise, let him who is in the field not return back. Remember Lot's wife. Whoever seeks to gain his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life will preserve it. I say to you most solemnly, in night there will be two men in one bed, and one will be taken, the other left. There will be two women grinding together, one will be taken, the other left. And they said to him, "Where, Lord?" Jesus said to them, "Where the body is, there eagles will gather together." The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. All together, praise, 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 praise to Jesus, now and evermore. The word is a lamp for my feet and a light for my path. The word is the Gospel, why for me our sin. Please be seated. The first reading talks about don't follow any strange doctrines. Follow the Son of God. John, in his letter, exhorting the community. And today Jesus is also talking to us, don't follow the waves that are going around, but follow the Son of God. And the disaster came, like the day of Noah, disaster came the day of the Lord, and all were destroyed. And Jesus warns us, anyone who tries to preserve her life will lose it. But one who loses his life for God's kingdom will find it. It's a strange doctrine again to follow, which means we need to follow the instruction of Jesus who came to give life, life in all its fullness. During the retreat, the revelation that came through the preacher to me is, you are special and God cares for you and He has a plan for you. I was really touched. I am special, God cares for me and He has a plan for me. Can we also say the same thing to all of us? That God cares for you, you are special in the eyes of God, you are chosen, and God has a plan for you. Prophet Jeremiah, chapter 29, verse 11 and 12. I repeat, there are two verses that we are going to read now. Prophet Jeremiah, chapter 29, verses 11 and 12. It says, Hindi mein, ki Parmeshwar kehta hai, aapke liye meri jo nirdharit yojana hai, wo tumhare hit ke hai, ahit ke nahi hai. आप आकर मेरी प्रार्थना करोगे तो स्वर्ग से मैं आपकी पुकार और प्रार्थना सुनूंगा. प्लीज रीड इन इंग्लिश.
आई नो व्हाट प्लान्स आई हैव फॉर यू.
आई नो व्हाट प्लान्स आई हैव फॉर यू. declares the Lord.
Plan is for
peace
and not for disaster.
Plans
to give you hope and the future.
The hope and the future.
When you call upon me
and come and pray to me,
I will listen to you.
See, God is ready to listen, but we don't have time to pray. We don't have time to read the Bible. We don't have time to reflect. We have time for others, so many things. We need to prioritize our program. Today, you know, many of you have come here. It's a privilege for you to be here. There are those who have come first time. We welcome them in the beginning only. But what is our takeaways today? Are we going to go back? You know how? Father, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be. Father, when is the next program, Father? No transformation has taken place. We are going back as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be. What transformation can come about? Unless and until I surrender my problems, my difficulties, my shortcomings, my limitations. Some people, when they come to me, their limitation, they get irritated, they get angry, they get aggressive. They don't want to be corrected. You know why? They don't want to change. They want others to change. It can happen in a family also. Wife wants to change the husband, and husband wants to not really literally change the transformation. So, today, for transformation, Mother Mary is going to give us three important P's, which we always give. Okay? The first P is prayer. That is the Fatima messenger, it's not my message. The power of prayer. We Catholics, we pray. You know how we pray? Our Father, Hail Mary, ask us. Or the Fathers pray the breviary. The prayer from the head, not from the heart. What I know by heart. When we ask you to pray spontaneously, no one opens the mouth because we have not been taught. The real prayer is prayer from the heart. That I feel. And suppose I make a mistake, people laugh at me. Why? And because of that, I am not ready to open my mouth. Because I don't know English. I don't know how to form a sentence. A problem. Prayer is spontaneous prayer. Something that comes from a heart to speak out. Last time I told you, last Saturday, again I am telling you, in the pandemic you are supposed to wear a mask, but don't keep your mouth shut. You want to pray, you pray, open your mouth and pray and talk to God. Number two is penance. What is penance? Sacrifice. We made a sacrifice of getting in the morning, up early in the morning, coming to the church. We have come here, but some of you are not focused for what you have come. So as soon as you come now, you go here and there. Or you go to buy vada pav or karjat, or where the chikki wala is. You are disoriented. You have come here now. Ask Mother Mary. I have come here with a specific intention. So that is sacrifice other things and focus. That is called penance. I make a penance by not talking too much. I make a penance by not eating too much. That is a penance. With Mother Mary is asking the small children, they don't even understand. And one thing I like about Mother Mary has not appeared to any fathers who has been rectors and parish priests and bishops. She has only appeared to the ordinary people. That is another thing. It's better to be an ordinary person, not having any designation. No, call her up. Main idhar ka ye hu wo hu. Kuch fayda nahi. The king wanted to see Mother Mary. So in month of August, the fourth apparition, he put them in the prison. He said, when Mother Mary comes, even I will have a darshan. She did not come on. It's here, the darshan there. It's given here. Instead of 13th August, when the children were released from the jail, on the 17th, 18th, 19th, she came and met the children again. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ordinary people. learn from this. People must know that God speaks to ordinary people in an extraordinary manner, the way we are celebrating the apparition of the Blessed Virgin Mary, penance. And these two will bring us peace, security, tranquility, and prosperity. Peace. To experience peace, many of us are not at peace with ourselves. We want to conquer. We want to change others. We will not change ourselves. It's a problem that we have. Today, in this sanctuary, we are going to take three P's: prayer, penance, and peace, experiencing peace. May Mother Mary, who gave this message to the three shepherd children, we may take this message to our home. And when the people at home, those who have not come, when they see you, little bit transformed, not getting aggressive, becoming calm and cool, that means some change has taken place in my mother or my son or my, you know, my husband, my family member. They should experience that. So today, during this Eucharistic celebration, let us pray. Let us also pray for this pandemic, which is becoming more of fatigue now. People are tired. It has become a denial. Nothing will happen. If something happens, nothing can be done. And we don't know what is happening really, because for the last 7-8 months, with such a big technology and advanced technology, we can't find a cure. We can't find what is happening, where it is coming from. It's a mystery. Life is a mystery to be solved, not a problem to be lived. Let us live this mystery of life. And God has kept us still alive during this entire COVID-19 crisis, and is still keeping us alive. He has a plan. Plan for our well-being, not for our destruction. Plan to bring prosperity, not a disaster. And the last part says, if you pray to me, I will hear from heaven above and answer all your prayers. Please stand now. Keep your palms open. Spontaneously let us bring before Jesus anything that you want to ask for. There is no organized prayer of the faithful by one person's head, but everyone's heart is full of request, prayer. Anyone wants to pray in a short sentences, please pray and we will respond. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Say that. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for Father Louis and all the organizing team, those who have made this prayer possible today, in spite of the lockdown, in spite of the restriction. Lord, we have got actual worship to participate today. For this, we pray in a special way for all those who have organized, all those who are involved in today's service. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Response, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Anyone wants to pray? Our response, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, I'd like to lift up all the devotees who have come today, those who have taken time to be here. Bless each one of them, their families, their intentions, and their intercession. For this, let us pray to the Lord. Response, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, I want to praise and thank you for this beautiful day, Lord. Thank you for this gift of life, Lord. Thank you for this beautiful shrine that you give us to come and worship you, my Lord Jesus. Lord, we surrender to you all the sick and the suffering, Lord, who especially right now are struggling for the air that we are breathing, Lord. But you have blessed us with this air, Lord, and we just want to give you all praise, all glory, all thanks.
Response?
Praise to you, Lord.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Those who come first time, that is not going to be last time today. Lord, bless them, that they may experience your healing touch and the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
I like to pray also for our local Catholic community here. We are supposed to be the light and the salt to the people in Karjat. Lord, all the sisters of different congregations, the fathers and the church, the parish team here, we pray that we may become the salt and the light to the nations. We also pray for all those who ask for our prayers, intercession, those who celebrate their birthdays, and those who want to make a firm decision to change their life. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, in the celebration of the memorial of the death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly pray that, partaking of body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together, Francis, our Pope, offer a gracious salvation to all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we also may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
join in singing, Jesus, you are my salvation.
Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to transform in what we consume. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and praise the Mass in the
day. Thanks be to God.
Hymn on page 77, hymn number 8. Oh,